Rabindranath Tagore and Albert Einstein met on July 14, 1930 in Berlin, Germany. They had a brief conversation about the nature of reality and it was published in Modern Review Journal in 1931. Here's the conversation in its entirety. At the end, I'll try to explain it. You've been busy hunting down with mathematics and two ancient entities, time and space, while I've been lecturing this country on the eternal world of man, the universe of reality. Do you believe in divine isolated from the world? Not isolated. The infinite personality of man comprehends the universe. There cannot be anything that cannot be subsumed by the human personality, and this proves that the truth of the universe is human truth. There are two different conceptions about the nature of the universe. The world as a unity dependent on humanity, and the world as reality independent of human factor. When our universe is in harmony with man, the eternal, we know its truth. We feel it as beauty. This is purely human conception of the universe. The world is a human world. The scientific view of it is also that of a scientific man. Therefore, the world apart from us does not exist. It's a relative world, depending for its reality upon our consciousness. There is some standards of reason and enjoyment which gives its truth, the standard of the eternal man whose experiences are made possible through our experiences. This is a realization of human entity. Yes, one eternal entity. We have to realize it through our emotions and activities. We realize a supreme man who has no individual limitations through our limitations. Science is concerned with that which is not confined to individuals. It is the impersonal human world of truths. Religion realizes these truths and links them up with our deeper needs. Our individual consciousness of truth gains universal significance. Religion applies values to truth, and we know truth as good through our harmony with it. Truth, then, or beauty, is not independent of man? No, I do not say so. If there were no human beings anymore, the Apollo Belvedere no longer would be beautiful. No? I agree with this conception of beauty, but not with regard to truth. Why not? Truth is realized through men. I cannot prove my conception is right, but that's my religion. Beauty is in the ideal of perfect harmony, which is in the universal being. Truth is the perfect comprehension of the universal mind. We individuals approach it through our own mistakes and blunders, through our accumulated experience, through our illumined consciousness. How otherwise can we know truth? I cannot prove, but I believe in the Pythagorean argument that the truth is independent of human beings. It is a problem of the logic of continuity. Truth, which is one with the universal being, must be essentially human. Otherwise, whatever we individuals realize as true never can be called truth, at least the truth which is described as scientific, and which only can be reached through the process of logic, in other words, by the organ of thought, which is human. According to the Indian philosophy, there is Brahman, the absolute truth, which cannot be conceived by the isolation of the individual mind or described by words, but can be realized only by merging the individuals in its infinity. But such a truth cannot belong to science. The nature of truth which we are discussing is an appearance, that is to say, what appears to be true to the human mind, and therefore is human, and may be called Maya, or illusion. It's no illusion of the individual, but of the species. The species also belong to unity, to humanity, therefore the entire human mind realizes truth. The Indian and the European mind meet in a common realization. The word species is used in German for all human beings. As a matter of fact, even the apes and the frogs would belong to it. The problem is whether truth is independent of our consciousness. What we call truth lies in the rational harmony between the subjective and objective aspects of reality, both of which belong to the superpersonal man. We do things with our mind, even in our everyday life, for which we are not responsible. The mind acknowledges realities outside of it, independent of it. For instance, nobody can be in this house, yet that table remains where it is. Yes, it remains outside the individual mind, but not the universal mind. The table is that which is perceptible by some kind of consciousness we possess. If nobody were in the house, the table would exist all the same. But this is already illegitimate from your point of view because we cannot explain what it means that the table is there independently of us. Our natural point of view in regard to the existence of truth apart from humanity cannot be explained or proved. but it's a belief which nobody can lack, not even primitive beings. We attribute to truth a superhuman objectivity. It is indispensable for us. This reality, which is independent of our existence and our experience and our mind, though we cannot say what it means. In any case, if there be any truth absolutely unrelated to humanity, then for us it's absolutely non-existent. Then I'm more religious than you are. My religion is in the reconciliation of the super-personal man, the universal spirit, and my own individual being. Okay, let me try to explain a few things. Einstein believed that reality exists outside human observation, intervention, and consciousness. His theory of general relativity postulates that four dimensions of space-time, which has a curvature, created by gravity and depending on the mass of the object, time slows down or speeds up. His special theory of relativity said that the faster one goes, the slower time becomes. Tagore believes that truth and reality depend on human. This was perhaps in the light of Heisenberg's uncertainty principle, that in quantum physics, particles, if we measure their speed, we cannot know their position in space. Niels Bohr had a debate with Einstein too around this time. Bohr argued that the particles don't exist unless we observe them. So Tagore is using that quantum reality to human reality, saying that reality is human dependent. Einstein believes reality has to exist independent of humans, otherwise we cannot explore something that does not exist. Tagore says the very act of exploring or the tool we use, i.e. science, and logic are human creations. Walter Benjamin, the German philosopher, once said that nature is subservient to human imagination. Fairies, gods, demons, and monsters all break the law of nature. They do things that are impossible in nature. Why? Because they are human creations. So perhaps human imagination follows the same law of quantum physics. Roger Penrose, a Nobel Prize-winning physicist, has a theory that consciousness is in fact quantum in nature. Quantum physics creates its own law, which sometimes goes against the law of nature. Penrose argues that consciousness is not a computer, but it is quantum in nature, thus creates its own laws of the universe through quantum effect. So, Einstein says reality exists with or without humans. Tagore says we humans collectively process reality, thus it's in essence human. What do you think?